Welcome dear students, today we are going to continue our first chapter of chemistry and the name of the chapter is Matter in our Surrounding. We have covered some topics in this chapter and we will cover the next topics of this. The next topic is Can Matter Change Its State? Dear students, from very beginning, from lower classes, you know that matter exists in three states. They are solids, liquids and gases. Here we will study that can a matter change its state from one to another. For example, you have seen water. If we talk about water, this water you have seen in all three states. Solid in the form of ice, liquid in the form of course, water, and the gaseous form is vapor. Now, you know very well, water can change its state from solid to liquid, liquid to gas, even from gas to liquid and vice versa. We will discuss, we will come to know how it takes place. Let's start with one matter, that is water. Now, what are the factors? How state of matter can be changed? To change the state of matter, some situations are required. They are factors responsible for change in state are temperature, pressure, etc. Let us start one by one. The first is temperature. First, we will discuss about temperature. What is the influence of temperature in change of state of matter? So, as you know dear students, we just talked about water or the ice. If we take the example of ice, when the temperature of ice is increased gradually, the state is also changed from solid state to liquid state. That means, increase in temperature, or decrease in temperature. When we increase the temperature, the solid state changes into liquid, and if we continue the temperature increasement, the liquid state will also change into gaseous. In the same way, in the vice versa, if we decrease the temperature of a liquid or of a gas, it will gradually change its states from gas to liquid or from liquid to solid. Now, what happens? What happens when we increase temperature? A solid, suppose this is a solid, we are giving temperature. It turns into liquid and further it changes into gas. Now, how it happens that the solid changes into a gas? How? So, you know students, you have learned that there is a word intermolecular space and intermolecular force of attraction and kinetic energy. You have very well already learned about these three words: intermolecular space, intermolecular force of attraction, and kinetic energy. This intermolecular space is the space between two atoms of a matter. This is intermolecular force, is the force by which atoms of a matter attract each other. And of course, this kinetic energy is, as you know, in the features, in the characteristics of particles, that the first point was each particle moves with a kinetic speed, with a speed, with a already possessed speed in that. That is called kinetic energy. So when we increase the temperature of a matter, what happens? As you know, after heating, things expand. So when a substance is, suppose this is a matter, when we heat it, it expands. It expands. The intermolecular space increases. The intermolecular space increases. As a result, the kinetic energy also increases. The space increases. Suppose earlier this was a matter, and when we have heated it, this will become expanded, and the space between the molecules, there are molecules. Now the space between the molecules, because the number of molecules is remaining same, even you are heating or cooling, but the space will increase or decrease. Hence, this intermolecular space will increase. As a result, now these molecules will move with more energy, because they will get more space, and hence the kinetic energy of the molecules will also increase. This will lead to the change in the state of the matter from the previous state to the next state. Here we took the example of solid, then it will start changing from solid to liquid, and if we further continue giving the heat, the liquid will change into gas. Is it clear? One thing is to be noted that when this solid at niscit or definite temperature, until it has reached to a definite temperature, this state will not change. Suppose we are talking about ice. The ice will start melting when the temperature will increase after 0 degree Celsius. Likewise, if we talk, suppose we have taken a substance which melting point is 100 degrees or 400 degrees Celsius. Now, when we are providing more than 400 degrees Celsius temperature, then it will start changing into liquid. That means the temperature of this solid has reached up to 400 degrees Celsius, and then it will start changing into liquid. If you will measure the temperature of this liquid, it will be also 400 degrees Celsius only. Mind it, this is an important point. When we heat a solid up to its melting, this is called its melting point. Suppose we are talking about this solid and its melting point is 400 degrees Celsius. That means we have heated this solid up to 400 degrees Celsius, and after increasing from 400 degrees Celsius, I have written here plus. Plus means more than 400 degrees Celsius, it will start to change into liquid. But if we will measure the temperature of that liquid, it will also be 400 degrees Celsius. Then where? And if you are keeping on increasing the temperature, this temperature will remain same. It will not increase, but the state will keep on changing. Then where that extra energy, extra heat has gone? That extra heat has gone hidden. That extra energy has gone hidden in increasing the kinetic energy of the molecules. That extra energy, suppose we have given 400 degrees Celsius temperature, or more than 400, we have given suppose plus 10 degrees Celsius. This extra 10 degrees Celsius will not be seen here. You can't observe 410 degrees Celsius. No, it will remain 400 degrees Celsius only. Then where this 10 degrees Celsius is gone? This 10 degrees Celsius of the temperature has gone in increasing the kinetic energy of that particles, and this extra 10 degree is called as hidden energy or latent heat. latent heat. Latent heat is nothing but the extra heat, extra energy provided after even change of the matter. Here we gave 400 degrees Celsius, the temperature at which a solid changed into liquid, which is also called melting point or fusion point. After getting the fusion point or the melting point, the extra energy can't be observed in the next matter, but it will be absorbed as supplement of the kinetic energy. And this, since this energy is hidden, we can't see it, we can't measure it, but we can observe its effect. This is called hidden energy or the latent heat. So you just saw that the extra heat is hidden in the form of latent heat while converting, while changing the state of a matter, whether it is from solid to liquid or from liquid to gas. But one thing you should know, one process is there which is called or phenomena sublimation. In the earlier example, we saw that a solid, when it was being heated, it turned into liquid, and after that it changed into gas. Did not? We just saw when a solid is heated, it changed into liquid first, and after that it changed into gases, step by step. But sometimes it happened that a solid, when heated, it directly goes into gaseous form without changing into liquid. In special cases, it happens that when a solid is heated, it directly goes into the state of gaseous form without undergoing the change of matter into liquid form, or vice versa. When a gas is condensed, normally it happens that the gas is condensed into liquid form, and after further condensing, it changes into solid. But in special cases, a solid directly turns into gas, and a gas on condensation directly turns into solid. This is condensation or cooling, and this is heating. This direct change of a matter or state of matter from solid into liquid, sorry, into gas, and a gas into solid is called sublimation. You might have seen camphor. Have you seen camphor, which is also called kapoor in Hindi, which is used for praying gods and burning? There, if you will keep camphor in the open vessel, after some time, after few days, after few hours, you will not be able to see the camphor there. It will evaporate out directly from the form of solid to the gas. This direct change of solid into gas or a gas into solid is called sublimation. Is it clear now?